presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Mike in Wilmington. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
Hey, Tommy, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Good. I'm calling to give you a compliment because I just want your listeners to know that you are on your game right now. I've been listening to you for a lot of years, Tom, and you are on your game. And I'll tell you, I'll never forget you calling King Dollar back when it was in the 70s. You saying it was going here, and everybody couldn't even believe that it could even dream that it was ever going to go back to the 90s.
I appreciate the feedback, man.
All right, pal.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. So begin a great relationship. Know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are, what the needs of your mind are, and what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women, and some of them make a good match for you, and others won't. The two of you only need to be like a key and a lock, a match that works. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 120, NASDAQ up 58, S&P's up 17, gold contract down $6.60, trading at $1,159 an ounce. Silver down 22 cents at $16.96 an ounce. Copper down 2 pennies at $2.59 a pound. Light sweet crude flat, $52.84 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note down 3 ticks, 123.28. 30-year bond up 6 ticks, 148.25. King dollar up 56 ticks, trading at 101.105. The euro is at 106, and the yen is trading at 115. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wonder what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You got another day, you got another high, all of the above. The SPYs hit 228.34 out here today. Dow Industrials are approximately, I believe it's like 52 points away from its high. We 47 points. We hit 19,953 out here. Stretched, yeah, stretched, but guess what? Bottom line, that 20,000 price point out there is yapping, talking, walking, squawking, all of the above. We have the Fed meeting tomorrow at 2 o'clock. You can expect the volatility to come in here, and I expect what you're going to probably see is that somehow we're going to spike that number. NASDAQ Composite. The Composite is trading up a 60 bucks. The Composite took out its highs last Wednesday. Right now, we are at 54.70. Two, and the NDX did it today, folks. So the NDX is the last major indice to get after its high. NDX is up at 73 bucks right now. You've hit a high out here of 49.60. Right now we're at 49.47. If we go over and we take a look at the Qs, the NQs, and see how we're trading coming into this close out here, what you have is this. The high in the NQs, the futures this is, is 49.16. Right now you're at 49.48. Bottom line is that, you know, we'll see if you get any type of sell down. We've had one pullback all day. That pullback was started at 1:30. It went to, 2:20. Bottom line, that's it. So gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract today traded down to a low of 11.56. We've done 131,000 contracts. Right now, we are at 11.59.30. The number to keep your eye on is 11.58.60. You stay inside 11.58.60, and not great, but that's important in the context of a bottom line breaking out, breaking new lows. We go take a look at the silver contract, what we have with silver. Silver contract out here, still much stronger than gold. What we have with silver, silver's down 22 cents. You've done 42,000 contracts. I got to figure out what's... They changed these. It's interesting. They changed these charts on me on the go. Interesting. Anyway, so that we've done 44,000 contracts. Bottom line is that silver doesn't want to go down. You know, we hit 1723 today. If we do take a look at the XAU, the HUI, which you have inside the XAU, XAU is up 76 cents. We hit a low today of $79.54. You rejected that low. Bottom line, it's running right now at 80.98. Gold Bugs Index, what you have with the Gold Bugs Index. Gold Bugs Index also rejected lower price at 176.93. That's trading 181. Now, the Gold Bugs Index needs a lot more than this. The Gold Bugs Index, now to get in the higher range, needs 195. Bonds, we take a look at the 10-year note. What we have with the 10-year note is this. 10-year note traded to a high today of 124.10. We are at 123.08, and it's having a hard time holding price. That's the bottom line. You know, my take is that we're still, you know, basically getting a bottom going here, but today's not a good indication that it wants to get off this bottom. What you do have is this, though. We've done one point. Let me see if I gotta find these. I'll do it during the break. They just changed all these charts in Bloomberg. Interesting. So we got to get off the bottom. That's the bottom line there. We go over to the 30-year bond. 30-year bond out here is trading at 148.26. That made it to a price point today of 149.22. Same setup. 148.11 is the number you want to keep your eye on. We got below that yesterday, rejected it, and we stay above that, that'll be a start. That's how that shakes out. King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? King Dollar out here, folks, got to a low today of 100.785. We are trading at 101.085. Now, King Dollar looks like it's building cars to try to get into the 100.600 level once again. This is going to get intriguing watching this shake out, particularly coming into 2 o'clock tomorrow, because that volatility is going to be high inside the markets, inside the currency market. They expect it to be tremendously high. Why? Because King Dollar, over the 100.600 mark, that's a valid break. That's the bottom line. But guess what? It hasn't got away from it. And when you don't get away from it and you already failed once, your probability is really good that you're going to go right back downtown inside the consolidation that we've been in since March of 2015. And if that's what we get coming into this meeting tomorrow, after this meeting tomorrow, then what you have on the agenda is you have a $92 to $91 on the agenda. Big numbers all over the place. We go take a look at the XLF, the banking structure. What we have with the banking structure out here, there's a sideways movement out there today, 96 million shares. That's a slight expansion of volume as you're going sideways to slightly lower. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 116. NASDAQ's up 58. S&P's are up 16. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 119. We get the NASDAQ up 60. S&Ps are up 17. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday at 20 past the first hour. Don't forget, folks, Basil's got an outstanding program right here every trading day at TFNN, 11 to 12 Eastern Standard Time. And don't forget, all the programming at TFNN, folks, you can get right on your cell phone. We start live programming Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 8 in the morning to 5 in the afternoon, Tuesday, Thursday, 7 in the morning to 6 in the afternoon. Check it out right at TFNN.com. Basil also got a great newsletter, The Opening Call. You can come test drive that right here, right now. 30 days absolutely free. Now, as you're over there, you can go to newsletters. You go to trading newsletters. You can test drive The Opening Call, 30 days absolutely free. What you can also do, though, is that Basil has just started a course that is still not too late to get into. Simple Technical Tools to Analyze Charts. It's a three-part course on the Chapman Wave. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
Very good. Thank you.
I hear it's a little chilly up in New England.
Oh, it's getting cold, but we had a little sliver of snow. We can't complain. It's already middle of December. I'm not complaining this year yet.
That's a beautiful thing. Cool.
It is.
So what are we going to look at today, Basil?
So basically, I'm going to describe what we have as positions for my subscribers to my opening call, what they will get in the course. And it's not too late, as you just mentioned, because it's archived and it's the beginning. It's the analysis. In fact, let me just do this. It makes it much easier. The look of the Chapman Wave buy mode, what it essentially looks like is I'm showing a straight line down, diagonal line, and then there are four peaks to the upside. And each peak successively gets an alphabet letter, capital A, and uppercase going up and lowercase going down. And what we expect is that the fourth peak, that's going to be peak D, that's where other things can happen. And it doesn't matter. It's so unusual to even conceive of a fractal, that is a design, a pattern that could be repeated in all time frames. Look, here's the Dow, and it's done that exact same thing. It pulled back from the May of 2015 high in the Dow at 18,351, went straight down to 15,370, 3,000 point decline. August of 2015, it made a low, and here we are, peak A, higher peak B, higher peak C. We're in leg D. Then let me show the design once again. There it is, the simplicity of this design that I'm showing. Now I'll move it away and I'm going to show you something else. In the daily chart, because we've been long since mid-November. We're still long the Dow. We're long the Russell 2000. We've got some other longs as well. But now what's really interesting is that we're making all-time highs here. I'm not sure that 20,000, I believe that the acceleration from the low, from the election low, was just so quick. And so many people had gotten out of positions, either heavily out of it or some part of their portfolio. I'm not sure where they got back in. And I don't think that 20,000 is such a big deal here as it is when it was 10,000. But I wanted to talk about the pattern that we'll be discussing. Let me show you. This is the S&P cash. This is a five-minute chart. And I went through this morning and I said, if you had to count each one of these peaks here out of the 12 peaks that we've got in this little five-minute chart, about 10 of them are peak Ds, and there are a couple that are Es and Fs. And that's the pattern that we look for. So this is what I'll be going through in the second webinar. So the first webinar, let me find this right here, part two. So the first webinar went through the very core, showing that structure and then trying to identify the wave count, looking at trend lines. I just want to show this for 1 second, going back again to the S&P, because there's something that's very important. It's hard to believe that at one single trend line, look at this dashed line. Look how it's going. I've got a technique that I call the Chapman wave inside inside track, and this is the repellent zone. On the bottom, it's the propellant zone. And look how many times this line, who would have thought that this line starting off on the 8th of December to today is still the most important line. The price got repelled, and that's what I discuss all the time. So let me go back to what we'll be talking about in the second of the series. So the first one went through the core, the basics, sort of like the naked chart that I add different techniques. The second one will go through the wave count, a review of the wave count, discuss the peaks and troughs. Then we'll talk about rallies. Sometimes it looks like things are going to work really well and the rally fails and it goes to a lower low. I'm going to be discussing that. The buy signal upgraded to a buy mode. I'm going to introduce the sell signal. All buy modes eventually close with a sell signal going to a sell mode, because that's how you reverse a trend. The significance of the peak D, what it means, the alternate wave count, and then trend lines, inside track, cups and arches. Markets are made up of cups and arches. And then I introduce the moving averages. So here, once again, is that pattern that we were looking at. But this is how I put it together. Here's what I call the naked chart. It shows candles.
Okay.
And this is the IWM. From that low bar, we've gone peak A, peak B. I did this the other day. It's peak C. We still haven't gone to leg D. I am anticipating, I'm not sure how it's going to work now, but we should get to a higher high for a leg D on the IWM, the Russell 2000 daily. But here we start adding it. So it looks cluttered, but when you start adding one at a time, each incremental moving average or a trend line, you can see in the daily chart even we've got this inside track repellent zone. You've also got the support. So we add the 9-period moving average, the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence, the slow stochastic, which is still at 95%. That's really good. So that's the systematic increase of adding to something that I call a very basic chart formation is the way we're going to go through it. And then what happens is that as we add these different things I discussed, what does the MACD mean? Why is it important? If you look at it, it actually represents the chart formation, this green line, that's the 9-period differential, the stochastic. What's important? Why is it important to be above 80%? Why do all the books say above 80% is oversold? And I say, no. Above 80% is what you want to see. That's where you've got continuous buying. So it's going to be such a fascinating, what perfect timing for this. At the end of the year, we've got the S&P at all-time highs. This is very interesting, and I'm getting real close to some kind of a sell signal. So the big decision for me now is, because we got in so nicely for the Dow, do I want to get out of this position? How would I get into the position if we only take time rather than price? Those are the things I'll be talking about tomorrow with the Fed coming out. It's really a very this is a perfect time, and now you've got this fantastic sale going on at TFNN. The donation, people, this is a win-win situation. It's the Tiger Dollars. Every year you have it, it's fantastic.
And what Basil's talking about there, folks, is that we brought up the Salvation Army Tiger Dollar sale today. That gets you a $25 bonus no matter what you buy, whether it's $600, $1,200, or $1,800. And then 10% of that cash value gets donated to Salvation Army, and it's in your name, and they send you the receipt. So check out Basil's workshop right on the front page, because as we're saying, you can come to this workshop, you can go buy Tiger Dollars, and you're going to save an additional 25%. Actually, you're saving 25% because that's the bump up, but then you're going to take 10% off in your taxes of the cash value. So it's pretty
cool.
That's
right. That's Basil, fabulous.
You have a great one, a safe one. Of course, we got action now, but tomorrow, big action, man.
Big action tomorrow. Thank you so much, Tom.
Okay, have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. We got the Dow up 119. Now, the S&Ps are up by 17.5. We're going to be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. And as you do come over to our website, folks, you will see, Basil and I were just talking about it, the Salvation Army Tiger Dollar sale. The way this works, so Tiger Dollars, we do this a couple times a year. The last, I guess at least 4 or 5 years now, time just flies. maybe longer than that, we've done this Salvation Army one. This is pretty cool. So the way it works is this. Tiger dollars are good for all product at TFNN, totally transferable, no expiration date. This particular time, if you buy, you purchase $600 in Tiger dollars, you get $750. So you get a bump of $150. If you purchase $1,200, you get a bump up of $300. You get $1,500 Tiger dollars to spend. If you buy $1,800, you get a bump up, you get $2,250. This is the first time that we actually gave a 25% bonus on all the buy points. Then what also ends up happening is that let's say you do a $600 deal, we give to the Salvation Army $60 in your name. Salvation Army, they're really cool how they do this. We just give them a spreadsheet, everything's on it. They send out right to you the tax deductible $60. If you buy $1,200, it's $120. If you buy that $18, it is $180. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. It's good from today until December 22nd. And the reason, and that'll be over then, because what ends up happening, we got to cut them a check, give them the name so that this goes in this year. But if you do have any product at TFNN, you're looking for any product at TFNN, a great deal to save quite a bit of money. Okay, so let's go over and we take a look at the Qs. So the Qs, folks, take out the high. They got juice underneath them, too. So it's going to be interesting to see as we come into the close here how this shakes out. The number that we're talking about, which I don't expect it to close under here, is 119.66. We've hit a high today of 121.11. You know, that being said, I can see this coming down to, the last low is 121.62. You know, it can come into that. It could actually come to 120.62. 120.32 is actually game. And what that is that that was from the spike this morning. As soon as the market opened this morning, the NQs put on about 45 points. If we go take a look at the, let's look at the strength inside the NQs. So the strength is Seagate Technology is up 4.5%. You got SBA Communication is up 3.4. Tesla is up 3.2. And Shear PLC, a drug company, is up 3.2. Alexion is still getting smoked. That's down 4.5%. Ceron Corporation is down 1.3. Regeneron's off 1. eBay's down 0.8%. Inside the Dow Industrials, strength versus the weakness. The strength out here inside the Dow is that Intel's up 2.2. Apple's up 2. ExxonMobil's up 2. Microsoft's up 1.7. Taken away from it is Boeing, down 0.5%. GE's down 0.5%. Nothing. 3M is down 0.3%. The oil market. Let's go take a look at that oil market. So oil's had quite a run. No two ways about that. CLF7. And tomorrow, 10:30 in the morning, folks, oil numbers will be coming out. Oil, this is a January contract. This is trading at, let's see what we got to do here. Let's see. Come on, get rid of that. There we go. Okay, so oil did a spike high yesterday. So the spike high got us to 54.51. The number to keep your eye on is 52.74. And with that, and right now, you're above it by 10 cents. Stays above it, guess what? You can go higher. This looks like, though, at first, it wants to come down to at least 49.90. 49.90 was the day that the OPEC got together. That was the high of that day, and that has a huge volume day. It's a 1.3 million contract day. If we go take a look at the XLE, which is the oil and gas equities, you're going to see they're just hanging at highs right now. You know, they haven't come off those highs, given any type of signal that they want to pull back. Now, the XLF is a little bit different. This is going to get interesting watching the statement tomorrow. And this is what it is. So the XLF, we're at $23.58. $22.32 is the last time we had real juice on the way up. That was on the 14th of December. What we have out here today, and this is subtle, you actually get a sideways to lower market with an expansion of volume. We've done 100 million shares out here today in the XLF. JP Morgan, we go take a look at JP Morgan. That doesn't tell us much. That's just a sideways movement with light volume, nothing heavy. Bank of America doesn't tell us much either. Let's go over to Berkshire Hathaway. Berkshire Hathaway continues to be the largest weighting structure. That's up too. So something's getting sold inside that XLF and out of that some of those banks in order to get down into those price points. What is intriguing out here is that the gold contract is still under pressure. In fact, if we look at the futures out here, this is what you have. Sugar is down 3.5%. Natural gas is down 1.3%. Gold is down, well, it's only down 0.5%. Silver is down 1.2%. That being said, guess what? These, if we go to the GDX, they're rejecting lower price once again. The GDX, you know, we got into a low out here today, $20.59. That's 21.04. It doesn't, you know, it seems like it still wants higher price. If we go to Barrick Gold, we take a look at Barrick. Barrick is up 38 cents. This is at 15.69. Now, Barrick Gold is the largest weighting structure inside the XAU, and that's in the higher range. Newmont, we go to Newmont. We take a look at Newmont. Oh, I like this move. Okay, this is going to be good. This is good. So Newmont's up $1.21. And it's just made it back inside its higher range again. That's a good setup, man. That's particularly a good setup. We were talking about Great Panther yesterday. Great Panther got some action underneath it. It's only up a penny out here today, but we just went from 140 to 151. And what you're going to have here, I believe, on the weeklies, too. On the weeklies, let's see, it's only a Tuesday, 13. Yeah, on the weeklies, we're going to be taking out that... Oh, at least we're going to be going into, because we've already hit the $1.50, yeah, $1.58. That means that we're pushing into the last swing point with volume. Last swing point at 13.3 million. It's only 2 days into it, and we've already got 9.3 million. So 2 o'clock tomorrow, folks, there is going to be some heavy duty action out here. You know, we're at all time highs. And can you go higher? Yeah, you can. There's no doubt about that. But guess what? The higher you go, the thinner the air gets. And this expansion here, you know, if you look at this expansion and just the expansion contraction, you're already over a 1-to-1. And that's just about on all the indices. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 125. NASDAQ's up 61. S&P's are up 18. We'll be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured.
These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Go over and take a look at Google. Right now, Google is trading at up 950 at a 798. You got a high out here. Let's see. So 816 looks like the... Yeah, 816 is the high. Now, this is going to get interesting with Google, too, because, you know, they've been working on these driverless cars for quite a while. So what they did also, they had another announcement out here today that they're going to start a ride-sharing service with Fiat Chrysler minivans. Okay, so Google's going to deploy a semi-autonomous version of the Chrysler Pacifica minivan that's developing with the Italian-American carmaker for new service as early as the end of 2017. What Google had done was when it changed its names to Alphabet, folks, it separated those divisions out. So Google's going to develop 100 to start with. They're going to develop 100 Pacificas to drive semi-autonomously. I wish they'd say what city they're going to start in. They're not saying what city this thing's going to start in. This is a brave new world out here, man. It blows my mind that if we actually are going to see driverless cars running around without the aspect of someone in the passenger seat. Let's go to Steve in Connecticut. Hey, Steve, what's going on?
Hi, I'm calling about the coffee index, the JO.
Okay, let's take a look at it. So this is the iPath Bloomberg Coffee Total Return Sub-Index. Let's see. So the note provides investors with cash payments scheduled at maturity or early redemption. Okay, so you're interested in going long coffee, right? Let me see what we have here. Coffee.
Yeah. I know it's like a little surplus going on right now, but it just looks like a good opportunity. But again, you know, not really a commodities person, but I thought the coffee would be a ripe time to pick in now.
Yeah, and I saw that a couple things yesterday, folks thinking, okay, that has come off the bottom. Okay, so I have the futures up first. So coffee's gone. It was trading at $1.79 a pound November 8th. It gets down to $1.38 yesterday. You get a bump up here. Yeah, I wouldn't be buying it just yet. What I would let it do is this, okay, so 144.65 and the coffee, so we're at 142, right? I'd wait for us to get into that level there, the actual future, and see if it has the strength. Because this is like a one-way move down, so right now this just looks like a counter trend bounce. Let me pull the JO up again. So this is interesting. See, this is why it's important. Okay, so when you're trading something like this, too, it's important to pull up the future, too. Because, see, when I just pulled up the JO, Well, it looks like the whole world's buying it, you know? Now, the differential is that, yeah, the people are buying it, but guess what? The futures, you know, inside the JO, that is an exchange-traded note that just has a loan behind it versus real supply behind it. And inside the futures, here's some divergence, okay? So that you bounce today in the futures with light volume, right? And the JO, you have volume. You get 500,000 going into 323. So in that case, I always go to what it is trading off of, and that's what this is trading off of.
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, it's like you said, it's right now maybe a little too early, but you know, depending upon the position size and whatnot, that's what I'm looking at. You can always put a stop into.
You could, you know, and what you could do there, so, okay, if you're going to position size, that's a great way of doing it. So if you do that, what you're looking for is this. Let me just bring back the coffee again. What you're going to be looking for is that you're going to scale, and what you're going to be doing is like, okay, so the futures are at 142. I figure you're going to get some flack at 144. Then what you do is that if they get the flack, that's no big deal. The real question is going to be then, how do they pull back again? And if then they pull back down into that low with less than 19,000 contracts, then you get action, man, you know?
Yeah, thanks a lot. I really appreciate it. And it gives me a different perspective how to look at it.
Yeah, well, I think it's what happens when you're coming off a bottom is that it's really awesome if first you go into strength and meaning strength, the downdraft. So you're going into a downdraft. If you go in that with at least expanding a little volume, right? Then when you pull back, though, if you're pulling back on that test, man, and there's no sellers, then you got a shot that you can start making it through that supply line. So,
thank you very much.
Okay, man.
Have a great day.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Thank you.
We go take a look at the volume inside the indices out here in the NYSE. We're at 635, so that's going to be still short volume. On the NASDAQ composite, we are at the composite should be getting some juice. We're at 1.764. That'll get some juice. That should do about 2.1, 2.2. That's what it looks like. And if we take a look at the higher volume stocks inside the S&P, this is what we have happening out here. You have Microsoft. I'll go back to Microsoft. Microsoft's up a buck. Facebook is up 290. That's getting a bid. GE's down 14 cents. You get Cisco up 45. Marbell's up 25. Exxon's up 181. Let's go over to Exxon, because Exxon has had a hard time getting over the consolidation that it's been in. So it got volume yesterday, got volume today. It's still going. So we're at 92.74, 93.62. It looks like it's going to get tested. So 69 million there versus 31. That's going to be interesting because that may get enough of the volume. I'd wait it out to see whether it can happen, but it's pretty close to the downdraft. See, Exxon had this vicious downdraft in July of 2016. It went from 93 to 86. Did some big volume. And 93.62 now is the top of that. If we go over and we take a look at Chevron, yeah, Chevron's strong, but Chevron's also giving a signal that this run here looks like it's just about over. So what's going to get intriguing here, folks, inside the oil market and the dollar is that a stronger dollar is going to be really tough for oil to simultaneously go higher the whole time. I mean, I'm not in a stronger dollar camp, but if you are in a stronger dollar camp, it's going to be interesting watching that whole thing shake out. We're going to know quite a bit tomorrow at 2 o'clock. That's what it really comes down to. My take out there at 2 o'clock, too, is that what you're going to see is that bonds are going to get stronger, metals are going to get stronger, and the dollar is going to get weaker. But in between that, volatility, I mean volatility in spades. We're going to see some of the heaviest volatility that I think we've seen in a very long time. The reason being is because fundamentally this doesn't add up, meaning that if rates are going up and the market's going up, that's a situation that is counterintuitive. And the whole world's saying, well, now everything's great. Well, everything's great? What happened? You know, everything was bad. So how is everything great and everything's great when the market's going up? And I believe things are good. I'm just relating the rap out there as to why the market's higher. Excuse me. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 105. You get the NASDAQ up 51. S&Ps are up 15. Let's go to Cooper in Boston. Hey, Cooper, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. Yourself?
Yeah, I'm doing well. Thanks, man. We spoke yesterday, if you recall.
So I'm
checking out a stock today called GKOS, Glaukos.
Okay.
I've been kind of watching it, and I saw it pop today on volume. It's getting close to a swing, and I'm just wanting to see what you think of it when you look at it.
Let's take a look. Okay, so the low for the year is 14, the high is 39. This is a glaucoma company. They treat glaucoma. So bring this back. Yeah, I like the setup, man. Interesting. Okay, so... Watch, this is a new IPO out here. It's been out here a few years, but what you have is this. You have a nice sign of strength on a weekly basis, a couple. You got the first one September, the next one in November, even though it went lower. That actually it didn't break the swing of 28.26. Yep, look at that, 28.72. Yeah, this thing can run to like $37, man, you know? That's on the weekly. Let me put this on a daily for a second.
Well, it's at 37 right now, right?
I had a 34.10.
34. Okay, 34 right now. Got it.
Yeah. Yep. It's a good setup. I mean, yeah, I like the setup. It is your next leg on this. So, see, it's pushing into the swing high. December 7th, it goes to 34.68. It does 523,000 shares. Well, today, it's pushing into that with 923. Most times when you do that, it wants to break it. If you break it, you'll probably go to, like, ICE. ICE is 36.01.
Okay, so $2.
Now, that's on the daily. But on the month, on the weeklies, that 37 is game.
Yep. All right.
Cooking, brother.
All right, man. Good talking to you. Thanks again, Tom.
You too, man. Stay warm.
I'm trying.
You got to love it. A little chilly up in Boston, I guess. No doubt about that. We got... I'd be happy to take... We got another guy coming in from San Jose. But, Paul, I'm happy to take you the next hour, all right? Because what's going to happen, as soon as you get on the air... this hour is going to get over. So coming into the NYSE right now, we're doing 672 million shares. Coming into the NASDAQ composite, you're banging out with 1.8 million, billion rather. So the composite is setting up for a couple billion share day out here. The NQs, they're selling these NQs down pretty quickly coming into this close. So let me just look at this thing again. So you got 49.33. This is pretty intense, actually. Because once you break, this gets interesting, which we just did. Remember when I started the show, I was showing you that expansion. Once you got back inside 49.39, your next leg gets you 49.27. Right now we're at 49.34. So we'll see where that shakes out. But someone just sold into these NQs coming into the close because we had the high out here of 49.61. You're 25 bucks off of that with volume. And where the key is here is that there's not a lot holding on to this thing between 33 and 26. We'll see what shakes out here because what does happen, of course, is that you have until in these... futures here, it's till 4:15, folks. And if this baby gets into that 26 mark, then that'd be pretty intense. Because then that would open up. That'd open up a full retracement. It'd be pretty intense if you get a full retracement happening in the next 17 minutes after the market, until the futures market closes. You stay right there. Of course, we'll be coming back with some numbers after the close. Dow Industrials up 109, NASDAQ up 49, S&P's up 16. We'll get right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Dell in Texas. Hey, Dell, what's going on?
Hey, Tom.
How you doing, man?
My call. Great.
Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
I love your show. I just stumbled upon it probably, maybe a month ago.
And how'd you find us?
I found you on YouTube.
YouTube. That's a beautiful thing. Well, we appreciate you growling and prowling with us. Welcome to the Tiger family, man.
Wow.
I like it. Totally.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't make assumptions. Ask for what you want. This is a great card. Find the courage to ask for what you want. Others have the right to tell you yes or no, but you always have the right to ask. Likewise, everyone has the right to ask you for what they want, and you have the right to say yes or no. Likewise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 114, NASDAQ up 51, S&P's up 17, gold contract down $5.20, trading at $11.60 an ounce, silver down 21 cents, $16.97 an ounce, platinum up $3, $9.35 an ounce, copper down 2 pennies at $2.59 a pound, light sweet crude flat, $52.81 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note flat, 123.31. 30-year bond up 12 ticks, 148.31. Both the notes and the bonds continue to have a hard time holding on to higher price. We'll see whether they can make that bottom. My take is that they're making that bottom, but man, they're having a hard time doing it. King dollar up 66 ticks, traded at 101.115. What King Dollar has happening right now, folks, is this. So we had 2 weeks ago, King Dollar breaks topside over the 100.600 area. That has been in a consolidation since March of 2015. Breaks topside. Last week, goes downtown, comes right back under and inside the consolidation. Monster volume. Goes topside again, also last week. Guess what, though? We have two high-volume lows under the 100.600 area. Yesterday, you tested the high of December 5th, failed on price, failed on volume. King Dollar looks to me like we're going to have another test, and I expect, guess what? 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, that test is going to be had. There's going to be a lot of tests at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, folks. Euro. Euro's trading at 106, and the yen is at 115.20. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Well, what's going on in your world? In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You, SPY got to 228.34. You did 101 million shares. Dow Industrials, all of 47 points away from 20,000. That thing will get tagged tomorrow sometime. You're that close to that number, why not, right? NASDAQ Composite, what do we have with the Composite? Composite took out the highs a few days ago. We got to 54.86 today. You're at 54.63. The last high up here was 54.50. So bottom line, you're still at a higher price. NDX 100, that was the NDX 100 chance today. Not chance, the bottom line, they did it. NDX goes to a price point of 49.60. We closed at 49.35. 49.11 is the number. Bottom line, if we take a look at the three Qs. Now, the NASDAQ didn't get volume. The three Qs did, though. The three Qs, we did 53 million shares. It wouldn't be a case of an ABC structure on the way up because you still have volume on the way down. The definition of an ABC structure on the way up is you go up with volume, you pull back with lighter volume, you go up with volume. In this case, we'll pull back with volume. But bottom line, it's over those highs. The highs we're talking about is $119.66. What you did have is that coming into the close out here, we basically closed where we opened this morning. Well, actually a little bit higher, 10 minutes into it. But someone threw some real juice coming into this into the close also. The last trade out here was $2.7 million. We'll see where that shakes out. Gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold continues to hold that 1152 area. We got to 1156 out here today. You did 1.3 million contracts. That is going into, let's get this baby up here. So, okay. So on this contract, yeah, this is cool. Okay, so we got to a low yesterday in the gold contract of 1152.50. That was testing the prior low that had 222,000 contracts. We did 167,000, so we rejected lower price. We had lighter volume, and you're still in that range. So what we need now is a sign of strength. Silver, what do we do with the silver contract? Silver is stronger than gold, still is stronger than gold. SIH7, it's pretty amazing, folks, that we're in. All the contracts now are in 2017. That's it, that's coming right up, baby, 2017. So, silver out here. Silver showed its strength on December 7th. So December 7th, silver goes from a price point of $16.70 to $17.30. Does 65,000 contracts. Today we did 44,000, you do a sideways move. I like how silver's set up. Silver looks to me like 17.23 is gonna be game. If we get that to be game, we're gonna see some action inside this market. Well, bottom line, we're gonna see action in all these markets when this statement comes out tomorrow. We're gonna take a look at the XAU and the HUI. XAU and the HUI, they both look pretty good out here today. We had the XAU up 92 cents, $81.19. Now that is in the higher range. Gold Bugs Index has a lot more work to do. They both rejected lower price out here today. Gold Bugs Index was trading at 176.93, closed at 181.91. That being said, that has to get up into the 195.61 area to get big traction. Bonds, what do we got in the bond market? Bond market, folks, is having a tough time holding on to price here. We take a look at this, and what you're going to see is that the 10-year, excuse me, folks, we traded to 124.10, and what we didn't get is that we didn't get juice behind the move. You know, thus far, what the bond market has refused to do is go to lower price. Yesterday, you came into the low of 1.8 million contracts. You did 1.4, and you rejected lower price. Now you need a sign of strength. That's on the 10-year. 30-year set up the exact same way. 30-year out here, USH7, 30-year. That is trading at 149 even. And inside of this one here, what we also did, that's good. And inside of 148.11 is the number. So 30-year, got down to 147.10, rejected it. Bottom line, you know, we'll see if it can catch a sign of strength. And good old King Dollar. King Dollar's just hanging here, you know, a few ticks above that 100.600 mark that I expect is going to get tested. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you?
now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. So we had the Dow finish up 114, NASDAQ up 51, S&P's up 17. Let's go to Paul in San Jose. Hey, Paul, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. What's going on, buddy? How you doing? Thanks for taking my call.
Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it, man.
Yeah, absolutely. So I've been watching this market here and wondering what the heck is going on. So in terms, my question is about inflation. I was listening to Larry's show this morning, and the gentleman on his show was saying that there's approximately $70 trillion sitting on the sidelines. Since I'm really new to the markets generally, I'm wondering, when you have an environment like this, what does it take to get some of that money into the market? And if some of that money were to come into the market, how fast do you see inflation getting out of control, or do you see it getting out of control at all?
Well, you know, okay, so there's two parts to that question. And I'm always intrigued with this question, folks. Not this question, that folks say that there's $70 trillion on the sideline, or there's $10 trillion, or there's $5, okay? It's like, okay, so why do you have to put it in the market? That's what cracks me up. Do you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
It's like there are so many different markets, folks, in the world. Now, we happen to be in the market, meaning the stock market, but there are millions of ways to make money. And a lot of them, most of them, are a lot easier than the stock market, actually. You know, the mantra out here on a continual basis is that, you know, the large structures in the world get people that, okay, the stock market is going to, you know, be the one. But I don't buy that, first off, okay? The money's out there. It has to go in there. There's you know, like, you can trade, and you can actually trade things without something being in the equity market and actually buying and selling. I mean, there's a million things. So I don't buy the aspect that money's sitting there and it has to go in the stock market. That's the essence of it. Now, the inflation deal is a cool deal. So, and what I mean by that is this. Everyone has been waiting for inflation for like 10 years now, right? So right. What inflation is, folks, for, you know, you can print as much money as you want, and the whole world is printing huge amounts of money. But people are basically still not spending the money. So the way inflation gets going is it's the velocity of cash that gets through the economy that you're not worried about spending. So let's say that if you and I were in the same city, right? Let's say all the folks in San Jose, they're making money. Everyone in Clearwater is making money. Everyone in Boston is making money, right? And as you're making money, I don't care whether it's $10,000 or $50,000 or $50 million, you're making money and bang, you are throwing it right back in the economy because you're not paranoid that you're not going to make more money. That is how inflation gets going. Then what ends up happening is this, is that every dollar that you get, you once inflation gets going, you do not want that dollar because what you want is the hard asset because you know the hard asset is worth more. And I've been through this because I was, the first house that I bought at $14,000 in South Boston. And at that point, that was a triple decker, folks. It's worth $1 million right now. This is a six story, right? So what was happening though, is that every two or three months, this was like the fastness of inflation is that you wanted to get rid of it. And even at those rates there, you knew if you got rid of it and you could have a hard asset, that was worth more money. So we're a long way from that, I can tell you that. But listen, I think we've had inflation for quite a while and the stuff we need, meaning in food, in education, and health. And that's what has been really hurting a lot of people that are working for a living. Because it's like,
they
have no money left. You know what I mean?
Oh, man. You know. I can't go to Whole Foods and get dinner for less than $50 for me and my girlfriend, you know.
Right.
Maybe $75 and I'm cooking it at home.
You're cooking it at home and then you're still paying tax. So $75, you got to make at least $100 to get to $75, you know. So, you know, this is a great conversation right before the Fed tomorrow, folks, because, you know, when I look at the aspect of, like, the market has been on a tear, the dollar is up. Well, fundamentally, this dollar destroys our international companies' earnings. So, you know, I can rip apart a balance sheet in a second, but fundamentally, you know, that's how they go. So it's, oh, really? The dollar's going to go higher and they're going to make that much more money? No, they're not. You know, so.
Hey, Tom, can I ask you one more question about real estate?
Yeah.
How do you see the interest rates? Because I'm your son's age, and I'm looking to get into my first house.
Right.
How do you see the real estate market shaking out in a possible rate rising environment?
Go get the house and go get it right now. You know, now, okay. You got to remember something. Real estate is local, too. I mean, you're in San Jose, and so San Jose, you're probably buying you're in San Jose, you poor cat. You're happy, but yet, you know, in San Jose, folks, 1,700 feet in San Jose could cost you $1 million, which is, you know, I think you better come on down, move down to Clearwater with us.
I might have to do that.
You'll be really freaking happy, man. We'll get you a beautiful place in St. Pete. St. Pete is on fire. It's getting gentrified. You can get a nice 2,000 square foot place. Maybe it's $350,000 that will be worth 710 years from now.
I might have to go out there and rent one of your places and go check it out.
Come on down, man. I'm telling you, the whole world, folks. You want to really make some money? St. Petersburg's getting gentrified. Come on down, okay? Because, so to cut to the chase, to ask the question, your first-time home buyers is not going to affect, because people need houses. What it does affect, and it will affect, it'll slow it down. But just like if rates go up tremendously, I'm not going to sell my main house. There's no way because I get such a small, you know, mortgage. Even the interest rate on it. But I think what will happen, I was thinking about this today, what ended up happening is that some people like to keep, you know, building up and up and up. I just go buy a big sailboat or something. It's just, you know, it's, anyway. Cooking, brother.
All right, Tom. Thank you, buddy. Have a great one.
You have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Now let's go over to our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. And of course, don't forget, folks, Andy does an outstanding show right here every Tuesday, Thursday, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time. Now, today we got a huge show for you. Andy's got a great guest. Remember, okay, so if you're driving right now on the East Coast, West Coast, the Rocky Mountains, remember at 5 o'clock, jump right on your cell phone. You should jump on it right now so you can check it out. Just go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. You're going to get some great HD quality video as well as audio. Bot Chilton, he's going to have him on, who was a CTF commissioner, I believe, for 8 years. He's going to have him on the whole hour. And they're going to be talking about what he thinks these next 4 to 8 years are going to be all about. Andy Heck, what's going on?
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm good. I'm looking forward to the show today and having Bart on. And I just want to mention that last caller who was on, there's a comment in the den. I'm not sure who made it, but it said that, you know, if rates go up first, Duffy made it, that it motivates people to buy houses. I have to tell you, you know, I'm building a house here in,
Beautiful
Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And I drove there last weekend. You don't know how many people are rushing to buy houses right now.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. It's like unbelievable. And this time of the year is usually a slow time around the Christmas season.
Well,
and
yeah,
they're knocking down the doors.
And with folks, what's also going on is that you have the baby boomers used to be the biggest generation. Right now you have the millennials, which is 36 going down to 21. They're larger than the baby boomers. They just start. You stay right there. Andy and I are coming right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC-insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking with our man, Mr. Andy Heck, and of course, we're talking commodities. Now, don't forget, folks, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time tonight, great show. Andy's also got a great newsletter. You can get this newsletter by coming over to our website at TFNN. Go to newsletters, go to trading newsletters, Technometric Commodity Report, can test drive it 30 days absolutely free. So
that's right, and you know what? buy some Tiger dollars.
Yeah.
And you can get a tax deduction because 10% will go to the Salvation Army in your name. And then you'll also be able to subscribe to my newsletter or Tom's or any of the other great newsletters here from the hosts at TFNN.
And we'll just go over this quickly, folks, but we started the Tiger dollar sale today. Now, this is the Salvation Army Tiger dollar sale. What we do is that we give to the Salvation Army in your name 10% of the cash purchase. So
it's a beautiful thing.
Everything. Yeah, we've been doing this 5 or 6 years, and it's really worked out great. And the Salvation Army folks, bottom line, they're one of the best charity organizations out there, meaning in the context of what they give away versus what the administration cost is. It's like hardly nothing. So you can buy $600, you get $750 to spend. You buy $1,200, you get $1,500. You buy $1,800, you get $2,250. So there's big bonuses. There's 25% bonuses straight across the deal. When you buy $600, we deliver to the Salvation Army $60 in your name. When you buy $1,200, we deliver $120. When you buy $1,800, we deliver $180. They send to you directly the tax donation certificate. So it really works out well.
It really is a good deal.
And,
really
and the, way Tiger, deal all around. The way Tiger dollars work is that there's no expiration date. They're good for our product at TFNN. So if you're having something or plan on getting something, and that's good until next Thursday, folks, because we have to get it done before the end of the year so everyone gets their tax write-off.
That's right. So, markets. You know, I was on the break. I was installing the seatbelt on my chair here on my trading desk for tomorrow.
Right.
Because it is going to be wild.
I agree.
I mean, it is going to be like out of control, I think. I think, you know, look, this has been a volatile year, and tomorrow could be the cherry on top.
I think volatility-wise, I'd say it's going to be there, man. There's no doubt about it, man.
And I think that now you're going to be able to hear a pin drop in the markets until tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about that. The close was kind of tricky here. And, you know, the euro right now is kind of bouncing around. So, but 2 o'clock, man, forget it.
It's all bets are off, right?
Yep.
All bets are off.
Action.
So, you know, we'll see what happens. The dollar's in an interesting spot. What, 101 and change?
Yep.
Just a couple of, less than a big figure off the key support at 10060. Gold sitting at 1160, silver just under $17. They're going to move tomorrow after the Fed comes out. It's going to be the statement, though, more than the move, unless they shock us and either they raise 50 basis points or they don't raise it at all. That you know, then you're going to see, you know, craziness. But, you know, if they do 25, pay attention to that statement, because that's where the juice is going to be.
That's where
the market reaction is going to be.
Well, and, you know, when I'm looking at this, Andy, it's like, okay, so the expansion since November 4th has been tremendous, right? So, like, what are they going to say that you got another 1,000 points? Well, we'll find out. I know that. But it's like, wow. I mean,
yeah, it is wow. I'm sure that the Fed meeting this time is contentious because they're an apolitical body, but they're living in a political reality right now that they're not used to.
Right. Right.
So,
and what they've also done, they've been crying wolf for forever. So,
yeah.
You know,
well, they've been begging also for fiscal stimulus, and, you know, they might just get that in spades.
Well, right. Now they say that, well, Trump says he's going to give it to them anyway.
Right, right. So, you know, listen, I'm sure.
Maybe that's why they go up 50%.
50 points? I wrote an article today for Seeking Alpha. I said, I gave a couple of reasons why they should go up 50 points. By the way, they told us last December they were going to do 3 to 4. That was 100 basis
points
in 2016. And they've only gone up 25. They haven't gone up anything yet.
Well,
so 50 would still be half of what they had promised.
Right. And what they did, folks, is that they did that last year, meaning in 2014. Let's see, we're in 2015, they said they were going to go up 3 times, only went once, last December.
Yeah, 3 to 4.
In 2016, they said the exact same thing, and now they haven't gone up. Well,
right,
we'll
right.
Think it was up tomorrow.
So yeah. 50, but 50 would knock the socks off this market.
Yeah, it would.
I mean, 50 would be out of control. Yeah, you'd see some crazy move. I mean, I think stocks would tank. You know, it would be very interesting.
It'd be like, so we just heard from Paul from San Jose. You're just talking about people scrambling to go, you know, get mortgages, right? people would be scrambling like wildfire because what we don't know is that we, depending on how old you are, folks, okay, you know, when I was telling the story about from, you know, the $14,000, well, guess that? That was in 1974, okay? So the bottom line is that you've gone, the bull market really started in bonds at approximately 1979, 1980, because the rates had gone from 14.5, I think they had peaked out about 17.5. And then from 17.5, we all went down to zero. Well, it took, you know, it took that long. So
took a long time.
The market and folks that, you know, don't have debt out there look and say, oh, no, are we going to go back up to that? Well, if we do go back up to that, at the beginning of those ramp-ups, it's dangerous. But what the only way that those interest rates can stay high, folks, is that if everyone is making more money, because someone has to pay for it, so... You know.
Yes, 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 absolutely. The, the bottom line, though, is my first mortgage was at 14.5%.
Me too.
So, you know, 4.5%, to me, this is cheap money.
But think about it. We weren't paying the numbers that we're paying at 4.5%.
That's very true.
Yeah.
That's very true.
So we were dealing with much smaller numbers, which, you know, it's wild, Andy, and folks, I really stopped figuring this out because of the percentage moves in mortgages. Well, if you're making a deal with someone, you want to make a percentage deal, not a dollar deal. Percentages are where it's at. Because as things grow, you know, 1% growing is huge versus, you know, it would seem like, oh, I'm getting $100,000 a year. Well, I'd rather take 1% of
the... Compounding is a beautiful thing.
Big time.
You don't want to pay it, you want to receive it.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
All right, so let's take a look. We talked about some... Let's take a look at oil. I want to make a couple of comments here about the oil price.
Okay.
I'm very bullish on the oil price, regardless of what happens tomorrow.
Okay.
I think that oil now has a really nice floor at $50. Really, really nice floor at 50. If you look at, you know, there's a lot of congestion up here at 50. It was a big area of resistance on the way up. Now it looks like it's going to develop into an area of support. I think that Mr. Putin played OPEC like a chess master. I think that he used Iran as a pawn. He basically twisted the Saudis' arms, and now he's looking forward to a U.S. Secretary of State who's a friend of Russia from his position at ExxonMobil, who he's used to, accustomed to. He has a president of the United States, an incoming president, who wants to have a better relationship with the Russians, obviously, than the Chinese. And I think that that's going to be very bullish for the price of oil. And when we get back from the break, I want to show you something interesting in oil.
That'll be bullish until Putin walks into another country and offs a few more people, right?
Well, we'll see about that. But I want to show you something
like
really
that,
interesting after the break. I want to show you something really interesting after the break.
You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion.
While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns, as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking about my man, Mr. Andy Hecht. We are talking commodities, and he's got a great guest coming up at 5 o'clock. Now, no matter where you're listening right now, folks, check it out right on your cell phone. You should actually do it right now. So you'll be ready at 5 o'clock. Andy's got a great guest coming up. It's Bart Chilton. He was a CTFC commissioner for 8 years, and he's going to be talking to him about a lot of things, I'm sure.
We got a lot of questions for Bart today. No question.
Okay,
no
so question. I'm looking at a chart you put up.
Right. I want to go back to oil.
Okay.
And I want to talk about two things that are making me very bullish, and I think that crude oil is on its way to $60.
Okay.
Short order. This is the chart of the June 2018 NYMEX price of oil, minus the June 2017 price of NYMEX oil.
Okay.
So it is the term structure, the forward curve. And what we could see here is that on November 9th, November 11th, it was trading at about a $2.70 contango, which means that the 2018 price was higher than the 2017 price.
Yes.
And contango in markets tends to tell us that that there's healthy supply. We have moved now to a 60-cent backwardation on this spread. That is, in my opinion, very important for the crude oil market. It's telling us that market perception is telling us that, hey, we're going to have some supply issues perhaps.
Right.
Now, the other thing that's really interesting here is open interest. Open interest in the futures, about 2.067, 2,067,000 contracts.
Okay.
Tom, that is all-time highs, very close to all-time highs. We are currently undergoing the roll from January crude to February crude. And the contango in that is going up, which tells us that the longs are rolling and the shorts are not. But there's still a lot of...
Oh, yeah, this is going to be a dangerous roll because we went up so quick, so fast anyway, right?
There are a lot of shorts still in this market because there are a lot of people who are dubious about OPEC coming to an agreement. There are a lot of people dubious that OPEC's going to live up to that agreement. And the bottom line is, I think that, the thing that ignites a market is too many shorts or too many longs. And I think these shorts are hanging in there here because the price, although we had a spike on Monday, Monday morning, Sunday night.
Yes.
It hasn't run away and it kind of came back and a lot of the shorts have stayed in. I think that you get this crude oil up to 55 or higher. Oh, my God. You're going to see explosive short covering. And people are going to flip their positions and go long, and we go to $60 real quick.
And
we're on the highs of the year now, and I think we have more to go.
And what happens, folks, on a roll is this. It's not that you can't just take it and you hit a button and roll. You actually have to close a position, open a new position. So what I believe Andy's saying is that, let's say you shot the market, right? Well, it hasn't been that bad, 44 to 50, but that's bad. That's $6,000 a contract, okay? So what happens is that those shots may have not got a margin call yet, but guess what? They got to close that, and then they got to come up with more money to go shot the market again, okay? Yes. So it's going to be a bread-turning deal, that's for sure, yeah.
It's going to be, and I think that even if crude oil does pull back, let's say the Fed does raise 50 basis points, let's say everything goes down, I think there's going to be a lot of support below the market because those shorts are going to cover. Those shorts are not going to ride those shorts. Those shorts are looking for a dip to buy.
No, they just got a gift from God, right?
Right. I think the bottom line, you got buying below and buying above in crude oil. It's in a very interesting situation. And to me, the fact that June-June spread went from contango to backwardation over the last month, hey, that's important.
Well, what about the amount of shale, though, that sure is coming on
absolutely.
Right now?
Absolutely. Absolutely. But what's going to happen is that will be hedged. But that hedging is slow and steady. The short covering overwhelms that initially.
Okay.
So each dollar up, there's more oil to be hedged. No question about it.
Right.
No question about it. But the potential with over 2 million contracts of open interest, the potential for short covering is much bigger than the potential for hedging right now. So I think we get up to $60. I mean, it's feeling that way to me. We're on the highs of the year. The term structure is supportive. Even the processing spreads, you have the heating oil crack up at 1750 or so in February, 1720 in February. In February, you have the gasoline crack during the off season, almost up at $12. So all of the pieces look like... oil's going to go a little higher. I don't think it's running away to $70, but I think 60 is very possible.
Yeah, and that's, from February of last year, folks, that's a double. That's 100% move.
Well, it's a double already because it was 26.05 and we're at 52.40.
That's what I'm saying.
A double.
No, that's what I'm saying. Right here it's a double. Exactly.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right,
totally. And I think another $8, that's, it's highly possible. But look for support. I'm a buyer of dips in oil, down to the $50 level. I think it's going to hold that level here for now. Other things that are interesting, a little bit interesting in the wheat market today. We've had, a nice little recovery in wheat. Wheat has to get above $4.30 a bushel.
Yeah, 4.17, okay.
Yeah, wheat has to get above. And the other one that I wanted to quickly go over that I heard a caller in the
coffee.
Talk about the J.O.
Yeah.
was coffee. I continue to like coffee for fundamental reasons.
Okay.
There's a shortage of Robusta beans. I still like it. It came down sharply. You got to take profits and you got to buy dips in these markets. But I kind of like it around the 140 level. My stop would be below 135 on the coffee. It came down pretty hard, but coffee tends to rally early in the year. And if we can hold around 140 through the rest of December, I think we could see a really explosive move in January, February, March of next year.
And that's because of
a
shortage?
It's seasonality. It's a shortage. Brazil is an off-production year. The trees and bushes are not giving as many coffee beans. It's a very fickle plant, coffee. So it has on years and off years. And this year's an off year.
Yeah, and Brazil has so many problems right now. Those poor people down there, man.
Yeah. No question.
You talk
economic problems.
Oh,
boy.
Man. Corruption, right? I mean, that pay gate just doesn't stop down there, man.
Oh, it's so through every, from the highest to the lowest in government.
Right.
It's just institutionalized corruption.
Right.
South America, Brazil is the largest producer in the world of many different agricultural commodities. And I think bananas is one of them. And thus the term Banana Republic.
That's funny, man. Yeah.
Right.
Pretty wild.
So, I'm really looking forward to the show today. I really urge everyone to listen in because, Bart Chilton, not only is he a really smart guy who really understands the regulations, the politics in Washington, how things get done. And with this new administration, he's going to have a lot of great insight. But he's also a very entertaining and lovable guy. So it's going to be a great show.
No, there's no doubt. right here, folks. That's going to be coming up in 10 minutes. So get on your cell phone, go to TFNN.com, just hit Tiger TV. It's right on the right-hand side when you get it. You just hit Tiger TV, bottom line, bring it up. You're going to get some great HD quality video as well as audio, and you're going to get a great education for a full hour. And Andy, thank you so much for having him on. This is going to be, I can't wait. This is going to be awesome, man.
Thank him. I'm so happy that he agreed to come on the show for the full hour. I think it's, I think it'll be wonderful for everyone.
And all us Tigers and Tigers are going to be harassing you in the den.
Absolutely. All right.
Okay, man.
See you in a few.
Thanks, man.
Okay.
Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We had the Dow Industrials finish up $1.14. NASDAQ was up 51, S&P's up 17. And, of course, Andy's going to be coming right up. And Janet Yellen, 2 o'clock tomorrow, coming right up, folks. Stay right there.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. This is going to be wild watching this whole thing shake out here. So watch this press release. IBM lays out plans to hire 25,000 in the United States ahead of Trump meeting. IBM Chief Executive Officer Ginni Rometty said she plans to hire 25,000 people in the U.S. and invest $1 billion over the next 4 years, laying out her vision for filling technology jobs in America. Really? IBM said in March that it had more than 25,000 positions open globally and that it started to cut some jobs in the U.S. as part of a workforce rebalance in an effort to add staff with cloud and other specific skills. Over the past 5 years, IBM, like many other large U.S.-based companies, have been criticized for eliminating thousands of jobs in the country and moving resources to places such as India. In an op-ed piece in the USA Today, Romney said many technology jobs don't require advanced degree, and she encouraged government investment in vocational education and training. They're all liars. That's a total mind blower, folks. Okay, slice and dice. It's here. If you want to see something, the count on this, man, this is just going to be a normal deal about what people saying, what really happens. So IBM right now got 379,000 employees. The way IBM has been making money for, I mean, so here, I'll pull this up quick because I know we only got a few minutes. But if you want to see something, how their income has gone down. So since 2012, they made $104 billion. 2013, $99 billion. 2014, $92 billion. 2015, $81 billion. 2016, they plan on making $79 billion. Bottom line, they've been laying off people forever. And those people, by the way, some of them in the United States, but the bulk of their employees not in the United States. Public relations. So everyone just grab a public relations person, spit out anything. Guess what? Everyone's going to, whether they believe it or not, just spit it out. Because the way it seems to be working right now, you spit it out, you say it, and guess what? That's where it is. Market-wise tomorrow, this is what you're going to be watching. Bottom line, so you have 2 o'clock is the statement. It was a two-day meeting, started today. You get the statement tomorrow, 2 o'clock. Then you get Janet Yellen coming up on a news conference. So all of that, folks, the dollar, I'll tell you, give him. So remember, we start programming tomorrow morning at, what day is today? Today's Tuesday, Wednesday. Okay, at 8 o'clock in the morning. 8 o'clock in the morning, our man John Logan's going to be on. Check it out right at TFNN.com. We go from 8, of course, till 5 in the afternoon. And we're going to be live. John's got a great show in the morning. Then we got Larry Pesavento coming up. And then my son and I got a show at 10 o'clock in the morning. Dave White is going to be breaking the news at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And we'll see where this whole baby shakes out. The move is out here. I expect, of course, the market's going to be a mover. My take is that bonds are going to go up. Metals will go up. Dollar's going to go down. You know, who knows what's in that statement, but the way that this market is stretched out here, the dollar index looks to me like it's been trying to get into and test this area of these lows. And the technical aspect is there. The fundamental aspect is there in spades, because guess what? You get a strong dollar. You know what? These companies can't have, well, they can have valuations like that, but when more than 40% of their income comes from outside of the U.S., guess what? And this comes right off the mining business, folks. If your expenses are in U.S. dollars and you're making something and that's worth less, you're a history, man, and your history very quickly. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there. I'm Mr. Andy Hecht coming up next. TFNN.com. Hit Tiger TV. Bam! Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Yeah. This is TFNN.